You know when this starts? We never wrote that at the beginning of the song. In your dad's garage.
Oh, on the demo version.
Yeah,
yeah, yeah. Yeah. So
yeah. Did it just always start the piano? Just down, down,
yeah,
down, down.
So all of that stuff was put in on the final production. But there was a lot of stuff that we did. We added, we went from 24 track to 48 track, didn't we?
And back again.
We went a bit extravagant on it, yeah, didn't we? A little bit. But the song remained pretty much the same as the demo,
yeah,
didn't it?
Yeah, and I remember I was outvoted because I wanted to make it like a more of a rock record.
Yeah.
And I'm glad I didn't.
But then, of course, most of the rest of the album was...
Yeah. It sort of, yeah, it wandered in and out, didn't it?
Yeah.
It was like probably a good combination.
But I remember doing the drum track to this, creating the drum track on the Roland TB-303, and then when it came to the studio, we hired the Lindrum.
Yeah.
And of course, I programmed that again, and always the demo had some kind of magic to it.
It had a ghost in it, ghostly effect on it, and
even though it was only four track.
Yeah,
yeah.
I think probably what we would have done was made the vocals sound really, really good and atmospheric.
Yeah.
And when we did it in the studio, we still got that. It's obviously because people tell you, they say, you know, it sounds great, the voices sound great. And But I think when we did the demo, it was purely me and your vocal, wasn't it? And
yeah. I think it was restrictions of technology as well, but we were lucky to have the whatever was out at the moment. At that moment, we were lucky enough to have like the Roland RE501 Echo, which unfortunately I gave to Paul Bangash at Power Punk Studio, and then I found the plug-in just a week ago, so I've got
the, I've got the bits.
I've got it again now. So
is he going to send it to you?
Well, no, I've got the actual plug-in, so it's the same thing.
Oh, I see. Right,
so
right.
I can now recreate the promise.
Drums. You
know, well, the drums and the vocals.
Yeah.
Yeah, yeah. So
wow.
We're coming back in full circle.
Full circle.
Yeah.
And then, I suppose, after we'd done... It was a three-tape demo I took to the record companies.
Absolutely, and got
signed. We had a track called Breathless.
Yeah, but we'd only got half the song. You'd not written the second verse yet, because I wrote the first verse, the chorus, sent it down to you, and you got the deal on half a song. You got the deal on the verse and the chorus, and then wrote the second verse later. But the funny thing about that was the promise was... when we came to America and met with Virgin, the first words they said to us, "You've only got one song on your album."
I seem to remember you getting quite upset about it.
Yeah, well, I said, why have we flown all this way to be told that we've only got one song on our album? But we were lucky enough to, at that point, we'd already decided that we wanted Richard Burgess to produce another three tracks for us, hopefully to be in line with this. And heaven knows, Wide, Wide Sea and Sight of Your Tears came out of that. And I think, personally, they're as strong as The Promise.
Yeah, I think I'm in agreement with that.